the Matthews V3. Guys, it's day number 3 of the state hunt. Shot this doe at about, I would say, 40 yards, and she ran about 100 yards, and she's been standing for a good while, and she just bedded down. I think I got a good shot in her, I hope, but yeah, gonna wait, give her some time, and see if she's expired or not. But yeah, action this morning. Yeah, first thing, got out of the truck, we're walking down and saw a buck and like a knobby buck heading down, so got into position and I ranged the area like 55, so down to 50, and I guess the buck was closer than that, so ended up missing right over the back, and luckily found my arrow, but had a lot of mouflon in front of me after I shot at that buck, so ended up kind of going around and seeing what else there was, and I saw this herd and crawled in. Got busted at first from a doe that was roughly maybe 5 to 8 yards away from me. It's a nice buck in this herd that was moving up, but after that doe spooked, everything ran, and but yeah, I got a 40-yard shot and got him. But we'll see. Gonna wait maybe an hour or so and then try and check if this doe is expired or not. But yeah, day number three, guys. What's up, guys? Waited for about an hour. I noticed the doe was kind of hunching over, so possibly could be like a pond shot. I think my arrow flew a little bit behind. Maybe he or she moved when I shot, but waited a good hour. Saw her stand up a few times and she couldn't stand up, and she ended up bedding down multiple times, but haven't seen her stand up in the last 20-30 minutes, so just gonna wait maybe another 10 minutes and try and go on track. Right, so guys, like I kind of hit him further back than expected. Go over this mound and kind of glass and see where she is, and we'll see. Hopefully she's still in the same area, or I'll try and sneak up pretty quiet and see if she's still there, and if she is, I'll just maybe back out or try and get another shot. Nice one. All right, first kill of the state hunt 2021. Yee-hee. Got it done with Matthew's V3. Nice doe. Shooting the AAE Max Fletchings with the Victory TKO arrows. HHA. Kind of worrying for a bit when it's coming down. Stucked up real quietly and sort of white belly up, and didn't know if it was down or not, so ended up just sneaking in real quiet, and sure enough saw flies and made my way closer. Got him down. Day number three. All right, I'm gonna clean her out and Back him up. Back to the tree. All right.
So guys, got the meat all stored away. Work begins now. All right, guys. Back, I'm back to the truck, and who knows, maybe come on this afternoon again and look for Mr. Buck or another doe or you. All right.
What's up, guys? Came back in the afternoon. A lot of mouflon. Got to about, I'd say, 60 yards from this herd first thing and let them pass. All the ewes this year have babies, so try not to shoot any ewes with babies or offspring right now, giving them a chance. Then got onto another herd at about 45 yards. Some ewes in there, but just had to let them pass as well. Some does came in, but got spooked from the mouflon because one of the mouflon picked me off when I was packing up my stuff, and yeah. And then just before heading back home, see a pretty nice buck, pretty wide one too, easy 30 inch, with a smaller buck, maybe 26 inch or so, but they're in the bottom of the ravine there, and yeah, we'll see, maybe they'll be there tomorrow morning. But it's day number three, ending of day number three, but I'm gonna try again tomorrow, and yeah, hopefully a little bit more pressure because it'll be a Saturday and most people are off, so hey, we'll see. All right, guys, see you in the morning. Pretty good.